What you're seeing here is a key moment for the gene editing tool CRISPR-Cas9. That's because the doctors are injecting a patient with an experimental drug that will edit their DNA inside their body. CRISPR-Cas9 holds a lot of promise, but up till now, all the treatments in human clinical trials have been ex vivo. They have relied on taking cells out of the body in order to edit them. Like in a treatment for sickle cell anemia, researchers removed cells from the bone marrow of a young woman in Mississippi, modified them to turn on the production of fetal hemoglobin, and then infused the cells back in. But for many inherited diseases, like brain, muscle, or kidney disease, you just don't have cells that you can take out and put back in. Which is why the first in vivo trial, called Brilliance, is so important. So let's take a look at how the in vivo gene editing drug works. CRISPR-Cas9 technology is adapted from bacteria and archaea, specifically from a defense system used to detect and destroy phages. And it's really appealing to researchers because it's cheap, precise, and highly adaptable. It's also elegant.
Its basic principles are fairly straightforward, although there are many modifications of this and many layers of additional technologies now being deployed. But at its core, it's a combination of the Cas9 enzyme, which is really good at cutting DNA, and a guide RNA, which directs the Cas9 enzyme to a specific location in the genome.
This guide RNA is designed to be unique to each application. It contains a 20 base pair sequence called a spacer region that's designed to be a homologous base pair match to the cell's DNA. As this whole complex bounces around the cell, the Cas9 attaches to the cell's double helix at short sequences called PAM. The specific PAM sequence depends on the Cas enzyme being used. Each time, this unwinds the double helix just a little bit, allowing the guide RNA to check if there's a match. If not, the complex moves off. But if those base pairs do match, the guide RNA will continue to anneal to the target DNA. Once the Cas9 detects that every base pair of the spacer region is a match to the cell's DNA, it cleaves the double helix. And this by itself can be enough to knock out the gene. Scientists can also provide a repair template to the cell. This is the basic way the technology works, but CRISPR-Cas9 systems are being rapidly developed, so it can also do lots more. Now let's take a look at a CRISPR-Cas9 treatment in practice. The in vivo trial I mentioned earlier is testing a drug for labor congenital amaurosis type 10, a disease that affects photoreceptor cells in the retina and causes severe early-onset vision loss. To get the drug into the eye, the doctors performed a subretinal injection.
The surgeon makes 3 tiny incisions in the eye so they can put instruments inside the eye to remove the vitreous gel, which is needed so that the very fine cannula that's used to make the subretinal injection can be passed across the eye, placed very delicately under the retina to inject this small amount of gene editing drug.
That drug contains an adeno-associated virus vector. The virus is the delivery system for CRISPR-Cas9, so the researchers put the sequence encoding the Cas9 protein and 2 guide RNAs inside the virus, and the virus carries it like cargo to the cells. The target is a mutation in photoreceptor cells, in the CEP290 gene.
So the most common mutation in the CEP290 gene that's associated with severe early-onset vision loss is an intronic mutation that results in the inclusion of a cryptic exon, an abnormal exon in the gene, so the gene doesn't function.
Introns are the non-coding parts of sequences that get removed during RNA splicing. Exons get left in. And that one wrong letter means that not all of the intron gets removed.
So it's a great target for an early CRISPR therapeutic because all we need to do is cut out mutation in the intron.
And that, the researchers hope, will restore gene function to the cells. They're looking to enroll 18 patients, with results starting to trickle in 2021. But while they're going to be paying close attention to the efficacy of the medicine, the primary outcome is safety. And a lot of uncertainty still remains about CRISPR-Cas systems more generally. But one thing is clear. We are finally at a point where the promise of CRISPR-Cas9 is beginning to be tested out in the real world. There's a lot we didn't cover in this video. To learn more, read the JAMA Medical News article about the first CRISPR clinical trials. The link is in the description. And subscribe to this channel for more JAMA Network videos.